everything happens here itself in the prototype and optimize. I told now it will be undergoing a lot of cycles before it is perfect. And only after the prototype is working perfectly, and once all the customers who are using these prototypes, only when they are satisfied, then the final drawings will be sent to the next stage, that becomes manufacturing. Fine. So now you already have a very functional product, and all the manufacturing details are already with you. Fine. So when you have all these drawings, what is the first step that you will do?
Materials, which materials we have to use them.
Yes, ma'am.
Materials, sir.
Material. Material has also been decided in design stage itself.
Okay.
Fine. So I told you, material used for alpha stage is the best quality material we have available. Fine. The cost is never a factor when you are doing alpha prototype. Fine. And then later I told local materials will be used. Yes.
Casting die, sir. We have to arrange the die first to manufacturing.
Okay. So die may not be used in every product that you are talking about. Let us go ahead to the generalized steps taken. You are talking about, we are going specifically to a particular kind of product. Okay. Let me proceed and explain to you. In between, if you have any doubt, of course, stop me and ask the doubts. So when you have all the manufacturing data ready, the first thing we have to do is process plan. Okay. So when you have the product design ready, fine. The dimensions, everything will be ready. Fine. So first thing you have to do is the process plan. Now, what is a process plan, anyone? What is a process plan? You must have studied this process plan in other subjects as well. Have you? Did you study the subject called optimization?
Not yet, sir.
Not yet. Okay. Did you study a subject called PDPP, product design and process planning?
Just it's in this semester only, sir.
This semester you have. Okay. So process plan. You must have studied at least this metal cutting and what is that? Metal cutting and machine tools.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So really. Okay, in this, did you come across a process plan? I think no. Okay. So let me go ahead and explain to you what is it. So depending on what kind of product we have, fine. Depending on what kind of product we have, we will have to choose different machines for this particular product, correct? So for example, if there is a hole inside, then we have to go for, drilling, correct? Then if you have a circular symmetry, then we have to use lathe machine. Then if the surface finish required is very, very fine, mirror finish if you require, then you may have to go for stages like grinding. And if there are any slots in this, if there are any slots, then you have to go for slotting machine. Slotting machine. So there are various different machines, each with specific form of design, machining that is available with us. So process plan, it decides what machines the product has to go through, and if there is any particular order in which the device has to go through these stages. Fine. So some processes are dependent on the previous process. Like, for example, if you want to have a hole, okay, my mistake. This has to be on the outer side. So suppose you want to make a hole along with the keyway. So the keyway, we have to use the slotting machine. for the key way, we have to use slotting machine. Am I correct? So for the key way, I have to use slotting machine. So for this, we have to go for slotting machine. Whereas for the hole, we have to use drilling. So which one should be happening first? Can we do slotting before drilling?
No, sir.
No, it's not possible. Mm-hmm. No? So that becomes a dependent process. And that becomes a dependent process. So first we have to go with drilling. And only then we can go for slotting. But there will be some steps which are not dependent on the previous steps. Fine. So such stages can be done in any order. So process plan, what it does is it provides the steps and machines through which the component has to go. It also provides the time for which the time that each machining process will take. Fine. So the machine that it has to go through, the process that it has to do, and the time for time taken by that particular process to finish. All these details are present in the process plan. Okay. Now, why is process plan important? Can you tell me? In manufacturing, why is process plan important? Why should we do these stages? Can't we just go ahead and start manufacturing? Come on, try at least.
To get a faster manufacturing rate time.
Okay, so one reason is to get it manufactured fast. And this term is generally used when it comes to time. Lead time. What is lead time? Anyone?
Sorry, sir. No, don't know.
So lead time is the time taken for a product from the start of planning to the end manufacturing. Fine. Right from the planning stage till the product ends up in the customer's hand. The total time taken by the product is called the lead time. So by doing some analysis of the process plan, we can plan the processing correctly. So that even when there are failures in the different machine parts, we can always manufacture at an optimum speed and reduce the time taken for product buildup. Okay, is there anything else?
Decrease the errors of manufacturing.
The errors of manufacturing. Okay, that is an indirect way of telling it. It's not directly helping us do this, but because we are doing it more efficiently, there will be less stress on the people who are doing manufacturing, and naturally they'll be reducing the errors. Okay, but that's not a direct thing. So you must have heard of the phrase time is money. Is it true?
Yes, sir.
How can time be money?
If we can make the two manufacturing at a time, we do one, then the money will cost less.
How?
We are losing one, right, sir?
Yes, losing.
If we can two pieces at a time, but we are doing one for these mistakes, so
okay. So instead of manufacturing one piece, if you are manufacturing two pieces in the same time, yeah, you end up getting profits of two pieces.
Yes.
Is that?
Yes, sir.
Also, there will be a lot of fixed costs related to any product manufacture. You may have to give the rent. You may have to fill the electricity bill. The minimum electricity bill you will always have to fill, right? And that will be fixed for every month. Whether you manufacture or not, the fixed minimum will always be there. The room rent will always be fixed. The salary that you have to give to each worker, that is always fixed. So in the same time, if you are manufacturing more number of products, those products will give you more profit. So that is how time becomes money, right? So process plan will help us reduce that to a great extent, right? And this will help us set up the next step, that is machine layout. Machine layout. And what is machine layout? What is machine layout? You see, in the traditional system, what we used to have is there used to be one hall wherein all the lathe machines used to be placed. All the lathe machines are placed here. All the drilling machines are placed here. Okay. Drilling and let us say slotting also mentioned here. Then grinding and finishing equipment used to be placed in one hall. So is there a problem with this? What is the problem with this particular method? Anyone?
We have to move the pieces from lathe to drilling, drilling to grinding.
Okay, so we have to move pieces a lot, fine. So the paths taken by the product will not be straight, fine. It has to move from one hall to the next, then next hall to the next. Sometimes the product has to come back and again move, okay. So the paths become very, very confusing. That is one thing. And to move the pieces from one point to another, that itself will also add to the cost, fine. So if I have to give you a general idea about how much cost will be added by material handling, you know what is material handling? The name itself is giving you the clue. Material handling means taking the material, or either the raw material or semi-finished goods, semi-finished product, from one point, taking it to the next point. This is called material handling. Right? And there are various different methods used for material handling, right from the most advanced, like using autonomous robots, to the minimum advanced, that is moving it by loading it onto the cart. Fine. So various levels of material handling are involved, and material handling itself will be costing around 70% of the product cost. Fine. That means if your product, let us say, is costing 10,000 rupees, if you buy a mobile, a new brand mobile, if you're buying at 10,000 rupees, what is the cost of components which are used in this mobile? The cost of components used in this mobile and the cost of manufacturing, electricity bill, everything will be just coming to around 3,000. Fine. So where are these remaining 7,000 going? Where are the 70,000 rupees going? They're going into material handling. Fine. So material handling means bringing the raw material from from the market to the factory, and within the factory, moving the component from one machine to another, and packaging, sending it off for marketing purpose. All these things, they're called material handling. And material handling alone will be having around 70% of the cost of any equipment. Fine. So maybe the book I read was the old one, and this is a very old prediction. Maybe now the cost has come down greatly because of the different methods we are using. But still, you can get some idea about how hugely the material handling cost will affect the cost of any equipment. And that is where the machine layout becomes very, very important. Fine. So machine layout becomes very, very important. So machine layout, you have to keep it in such an order that component finished from one machine should directly go to the next, then directly goes to the next. And this way, if you are doing, there will be minimum cost in material handling. And also, while material handling, we have to be extra careful. If you are just throwing away the component in loading it like that, then it will again affect the quality of the product also. But by this process, it becomes linear and there will be minimum damage to the product as well as maximum utilization of the time. So this can be done only when the process plan is ready, isn't it? When we know what are the different machines through which the product has to go through, then we can easily set up the machine layout. If we don't know the process plan, we cannot set the machine layout. So these two steps are very, very important. So in machine layout, there is actually in process plan and machine layout, there is another term that we have to study in detail, and that's called part family. Part family. So we will come across part family, that that's again a part of something called group technology. Just 1 minute. Oh, okay. Sorry for the delay. Can everyone hear me? Is my sound clear? Hello? Someone please respond. Are you getting my voice?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So group technology also we will be studying in this subject at a later stage. Okay. So only after going through these two stages, that's when the actual manufacturing starts. Fine. So this last stage is called as the product ramp up. Okay. So this is where the actual manufacturing starts. And marketing, the first stage of marketing is, the assembly or packaging, taking it to the market, doing the publicity, and finally, getting the products in the hands of the customers. Once the product is in the hands of customers, is the marketing stage complete? Anyone? Does it end with the product going into the hands of customer?
No, sir.
No. What is the next stage?
We have to maintain the parts which are damaging.
Okay, repair is one thing. Repair. So replacement parts, you should make them available easily so that repair of the component can be done very easily. Anything else? So this is called after sales service. This is called after sales service. So after sales service should be very, very good. Anything else?
No idea.
The most important thing, I told this before also, is the feedback. Okay. So once the component is in the customer's hands, you should not forget them. Fine. If you forget them, then they will keep complaining about the products. Their complaints will not be heard. And these complaints, they will not go into improvements in the future products. Okay. So do you just want to leave the manufacturing after manufacturing one or two components? That is the question you have to answer. If your answer is yes, if you just want to fool the customers into buying your product and leave them stranded, then you can just end your product life cycle by giving the products away to the customers. But if you want to stay in the business for a longer period of time, then you should be in contact with the customers, collect their feedbacks, fine. So what good things they are talking about, what are the bad things they are talking about, you should try to get the feedback. And this feedback straight away goes to the first stage, that is idea. The feedback given by the customers become the idea for the next iteration of the product. Am I correct? So feedback goes all the way back here. And that is when the cycle is complete. That is when the cycle is complete. Okay. So any doubts for the today's class? The time is up. We'll have to stop here. Why I actually talked about all these stages? Very little of these will be studying in the subject, but I thought having a complete idea about this product life cycle will get you a complete idea about whatever you are going to study in this particular subject. So at every stage in the product life cycle that I explained right now, wherever computers are being used, all that part, it comes under computer aided engineering, CAE. Now SCAD and CAM are a part of CAE. So CAD, this is where the CAD is going to come in. And this is where the optimization means ANSYS and other softwares will come in here. Modeling like SolidWorks, AutoCAD and Solid Edge, all these softwares which are used for modeling, they're going to come up here. And when you're actually doing manufacturing ramp up, this is where the CNC machines are going to come up. And in process planning, there are different softwares used for, you know, grouping the different parts into part families and all. So these are going to come up. So there is a separate subject called CAPP, computer aided process planning, that we'll have to study here. So this is what is the thing. So everything that we are going to study in this subject are going to be a part of the product life cycle at one or the other stage. And that is what I wanted you all to realize. And that's what this complete class, I have dedicated it to the product life cycle. Fine. Any doubts with today's class? If you have any doubts with today's class, you can ask. A screenshot.
No, sir. It's clear.
Okay. Good to hear that. So this thing I will share in your groups so that you can refer to it later. So you can leave the class. I'll take the attendance. What's the next class?